Hey guys, Dynamite Jack back again as promised with a review of the 55-inch 3D LED Sony HX800. I spent a little time with the television and I'm ready to give you a rundown of the features. Now unfortunately due to copyright issues, I can't show you what broadcast HD television or a Blu-ray looks like on this thing, but I can however show you around the menu system and tell you what I think of the TV. So let's get to it. Here's the TV's menu system, which you're going to be seeing a lot, and if you're familiar at all with the cross-media bar from the PlayStation 3, then you're going to feel right at home because it's basically the same thing. You have a section for photos, music, video, TV, external inputs, network. Any real changes you make to the TV, you're going to do in the first tab, which is settings, and the product support section has an iManual. So basically, you have a virtual manual installed on your TV, so any questions you have, you should be able to answer them here. It's a pretty smart idea, and if your wife wants to look something up while you're at work, she can find it easily. You don't have to go digging around for the manual. You have all of Sony's contact information in case something does go wrong. It'll be easy to get a hold of somebody. And one thing I really like is the automatic software update, which does what it sounds like. It automatically updates the firmware on your television, even when it's in standby mode. The TV comes with several viewer presets that they call scene selections that you can click on and adjust the TV based on what you're trying to do. If you want to be safe, you just leave it on auto, but there's a couple other selections like graphics if you're working on a PC, or game if you're playing games, that you might want to choose. Cinema is obviously for movies, sports is for sports. They're all pretty self-explanatory, but I do switch it to game mode when I play games. It helps a lot with lag. The picture and display settings allow you to customize things exactly the way you like. So if you want to adjust the brightness or things like that, this is where you want to go. That's pretty much the standard features that you find on most televisions. Backlight adjustment, picture setting. A great place to go for calibration settings and information in general are the AVS forums. The people there know their stuff and you can learn a lot about your specific television. I recommend it highly, especially when you're researching TVs. Just don't stay there too long because you'll talk yourself out of every set that exists. You have an ambient sensor that adjusts the picture based on the amount of light that it detects. I haven't decided whether I like this or not. I'm going to play around with it some more. The next section is the photo section, and obviously this is where you look at your USB pictures. You have Picasa, Photo Bucket, and Shutterfly. If you want to look at your own photos, you just plug in a memory stick or a hard drive to the USB jack, and then go down to USB, and you can easily find your pictures. Here's one I took at the sunset in my backyard the other day. Gives you some indication of what the TV looks like, even though I'm filming this in 720p. It's not quite as good as it really is. Here's my wonderful dog. He likes the TV too. After photos, you have your music section, which has Slacker, Pandora Radio, Lollapalooza, NPR, and obviously your USB plays MP3 files. So if you want to listen to anything you have in MP3 format, this is where you go. The next section is the video section, and here's where things get really interesting. This is where you can find most of your web apps. You have Curiosity, Amazon Video On Demand, Hulu Plus, Netflix, YouTube. There's a lot more things than I expected when I bought the TV, and way more stuff than I could mention right here. But I wanted to give you guys a quick look at what you can expect. See if you guys see something you're interested in. I may do another video in the future where I go more in-depth and focus on the web apps. Right now, I spend 90% of my time on either Netflix streaming or YouTube. That's just the way it's worked out. But there's some other good stuff here. You can find podcasts and videocasts. And the USB section is for MPEG-4 files, so if you have video files you've downloaded off the internet, or converted from a DVD, they play just fine. External inputs is where you select the various devices you have hooked up to your TV. You can customize the names to make them a little bit easier to understand. If you have a PS3 and a 360 hooked up, for example. You have your network settings. I have to register my TV. And curiosity appears again in its own section. They're really pushing curiosity. Let's see how that pans out. Here are a few other things I thought about the TV for this review. The screen is plastic, so if you have a really bright room, then you're going to get some reflections. This is the case with most edge-lit LED TVs I looked at. Screens have a glossy finish rather than the matte finish a lot of older LCD TVs have. I haven't had much trouble because I don't have a light source directly behind my television. My lights are installed in the ceiling. If your TV is directly across from a window, then I think it's something to consider. If you're able to control the light in the room, I don't see it being much of a problem. If you have curtains or blinds, you should be okay. Flashlighting and clouding are something I heard a lot about and had me concerned about buying an edge-lit LED television. If you don't know what that is, it's light spots around the corner when the screen goes black or when you're watching a letterbox movie. Basically, it looks like someone's shining a flashlight behind your television. I personally haven't noticed anything at all like that, and I'm the pickiest guy in the world, and I was looking for it. So maybe I just got lucky, or hopefully this model is less susceptible to it. I always recommend buying a TV somewhere with a good return policy, just in case you find something that drives you nuts. The television itself is really lightweight. It only weighs 60 pounds with the stand and 50 pounds without it, so you can move it fairly easily without giving yourself a hernia, which is always nice. It is on the large side, so you might want to have someone else help you if you're going to move it. The stand swivels, and it can move 20 degrees in either direction to adjust for viewing angles or reaching the inputs. So all in all, I'm really pleased with the TV. I just watched some Monday Night Football on it, and the picture looks incredible. The 240Hz really makes a difference with sports. Of all the HD TVs I've owned, this TV has the best picture quality by far. It's a great set, and hopefully I'll get a lot of enjoyment out of it. If you have any questions about the TV, feel free to leave them in the comment section, and I'll try to answer them as best I can. As always, I would like to thank you very much for watching, and until next time, have a nice day.